Are hamstrings passive in a standing forward fold? No, they're not passive in our standing forward folds. They're actually active. And I know that this may be a bit confusing because sometimes we hear ideas out there that when a muscle is being stretched or lengthened, that inherently means that it's not working or that it's relaxed or that we're, quote, releasing it. And I know how intuitive those ideas are, but they're not accurate. That's not actually how our muscles work. And in a standing forward fold, here's what really happens. When we go to fold forward, our hamstrings, which live back here, they cross our knee joints and they cross the hip joints. When we start to fold forward, the hamstrings, they start working in order to control our descent. So the hamstrings are working eccentrically as they lengthen, on our way down into the forward fold. And then on our way back up, the hamstrings work concentrically as they shorten to lift us back up. So they're very much involved and they're very active in a forward fold. But just for like comparison, let's think about a seated forward fold. So in a seated forward fold, or like paschimottanasana in yoga, here, the hamstrings are much less likely to be active. There may be some activity going on because of the stretch reflex, but in general, the hamstrings, they don't need to work in order to hold us in this position. So they can pretty much just chill out. So like in this forward fold, they're pretty passive. But in our standing forward fold, it's different. We have the mechanics are different. We have a different relationship to gravity. And here the hamstrings are working in order to control us and hold us in the position. So now that we've established that the hamstrings are active, they're not passive in our standing forward fold, the next question may be, well, does that mean that our forward folds, like in yoga, are a good way to strengthen the hamstrings? So the answer to that, like the short answer, is no. And this is a good realization for us to understand. Just because a muscle is active or working does not necessarily mean that that muscle is strengthening. So those are not necessarily the same thing. To truly be strengthening, there are a bunch of parameters that need to be met. And when it comes to a standing forward fold in yoga, for yoga practitioners, we have probably all done this movement like a gazillion times, like so many times that we long ago adapted to any strengthening potential that may have been there for us. So a standing forward fold in yoga, the hamstrings work, but they're not strengthening in a nutshell. Now, if we wanted to strengthen our hamstrings, and personally, I think that's a very worthwhile goal, really for everyone, every human body, but especially for yoga practitioners, because in our activity that we love of yoga, we don't ever significantly or effectively strengthen the hamstrings in yoga. We just don't. It's not built into the practice. So if we want strong hamstrings, and I think that's an inherently positive thing for our body, then one idea could be, you know, instead of thinking too much about like a standing forward fold or uttanasana, one idea would be to try a one-legged forward fold. So if you can see, I've lifted like my left leg here, I'm standing only on my right leg. And then this is a little, like I rarely see this taught in yoga. So this is maybe a little unique, but we keep the legs side by side and then we fold forward. So now I've added load. I've effectively like doubled the load on this standing leg because it's, you know, I'm only on one leg, not both. And so this is going to load my standing leg more. So that has, you know, some potential to be strengthening up to a point. Another idea that's similar but different is instead of this one-legged like uttanasana, we might call that, we could try warrior three, where we actually reach the leg back and then we hinge forward. So again, this is on a single leg rather than two legs down. So we've effectively doubled the load on the standing leg. So that's more load, more potential for strength. And then like in warrior three, as we lower down, the hamstrings on the standing leg are eccentrically working as they lengthen. If we hold warrior three, they isometrically work to hold us here. And then when we lift back up, they work concentrically to lift us back up. So single leg forward uttanasana and warrior three are two examples of adding more load onto the hamstrings, which could potentially be strengthening. But again, as yoga practitioners, we have probably done warrior three a gazillion times too. And also just to keep in mind the broader picture, which is that these movements that I'm showing here are only using body weight, only body weight, and really just, you know, kind of the weight of the torso. So that's not that much weight. And again, we adapt to it really quickly. So those are some ideas for adding more load, but they're not great like long-term for building progressive strength over time. If we're interested in strengthening the hamstrings in a standing forward fold movement pattern, then here's what we could do like beyond the single leg body weight stuff. What we could then do is as yoga practitioners, be open and excited and interested about the idea of using external load in the form of weights, because strength training is really a whole science-based practice whose whole point is to strengthen us. So it's like super effective at strengthening. So I could add load in the form of a weight to my forward fold here, my uttanasana, and this would be called in the strength training world, this is a Romanian deadlift. So I'm pretty much keeping my knees where they are, pretty parked in space, and then I hinge, I send my hips back, then I pick up a weight and I lift up, and this will be working those hamstrings. So we already established that in a regular uttanasana, they're working, but they're not necessarily strengthening. There just isn't really enough load for that. But as soon as we pick up a weight, then we have added a lot more load to the hamstrings. And this is a great way to strengthen them through a full range of motion. So that's called a Romanian deadlift. And another idea, so that's kind of like a loaded uttanasana we could think of, like a loaded forward fold or halfway lift. Because in a Romanian deadlift, we don't usually go all the way down. We usually just stick with this. We usually go to about halfway. So a little more technically, it's like a loaded halfway lift in yoga. And then if we wanted to play with like the warrior three movement that I talked about earlier in a yoga context, that's body weight. But we could, again, hold a weight. And then here is warrior three. I have my left arm out just for a little bit of balance. You don't have to do this, but I like to. And I'm holding my weight in my right hand and I hinge down. And now I have added more load to warrior three. And now I have the potential to build strength. And it's a progressive long-term potential because as I get stronger, I can add more load by using a heavier weight. There are other ways to add load as well, like more repetitions and all that, but just kind of in a super basic way of thinking about it, weight is load. If you go up in weight, that will increase your load. So anyway, these are some good ways to think about not only whether the hamstrings are passive or active in a standing forward fold, but to kind of go beyond that and then think about whether they're actually strengthening. And if we are interested in strengthening them, just some ideas for what we could do. And what we focused on here was basically hamstring strength in a standing forward fold like base position. But of course, as we mentioned earlier, hamstrings also cross the knee. So they also do knee flexion. There are great knee flexion hamstring strengthening exercises. What we've looked at here today is mostly working the hamstrings or strengthening them in their hip extension function. So the like hip dominant hamstring work versus knee dominant hamstring work. And there are great things we can do for the knee dominant side, but that's like another video. So anyway, like I mentioned, hamstring strength is super beneficial for everybody, but especially yogis. And if you are interested in building stronger hamstrings, but aren't really sure where to start, or if you'd like to be more guided through that, consider this program that I created with my collaborator, Travis Pollan. He's an exercise science professor, and the two of us co-created Strength for Yoga. And through our Strength for Yoga offering, we have a super great program called 5 Weeks to Strong and Flexible Hamstrings. And it will lead you through a whole program over 5 weeks to make your hamstrings happier with you, stronger and happier with you. So I'll put the link to that program in the caption if you're interested, but you could also just take some of the information that I've shared in this video and apply it to your practice to make your hamstrings stronger and happier with you. If you appreciated this content, subscribe to my channel so you can stay up to date on all of the content that I share.